Sometimes I get a good feeling, yeah.
Marriage. Marriage is what brings us together today.
I said, oh, 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 hey, hey, yeah. Oh, it must be love.
You know it must be love.
So how did Mary Liz and I meet? We're introduced by my very close friend, Matt Yale, one of my best friends from college.
Matt and I go to Kellogg together, and
his now wife said to me, you've got to know someone to set me up with. You have to know someone.
And he said, you should go out with my friend, Peter. And I said, okay, tell me about Peter.
And I said, what are you looking for? And she went through sort of the criteria of what she wanted and focused on one aspect, which Peter's gonna kill me now, which is she liked a guy with a lot of hair. And I was like, I got the guy for you, Uncle Petro. You know, Petro is a little bit challenged on the top with the hair, but he has made up for it with hair in other places. And
Matt said, you should go out with him, he's a great guy.
And he called me up and he said, I have a great girl for you to meet. He told me a little bit about her. She sounded fantastic.
Mary Liz is terrific, a very pretty girl. Very, very smart, kind. She's got the temperament to deal with Peter, which is, I would go on the line and say saintly. It was a perfect match.
He said, Peter has kind of an interesting job. And I said, what does that mean? He's unemployed? And Matt Yale said, no, he owns a race car team.
In January of 2000, I acquired the assets of a recently defunct professional top fuel drag racing team. We then embarked on one of the greatest runs in car racing history. And we won 40 races in 5.5 years. We won 4 consecutive championships. We really put together something special.
And he made dreams come true. So our first date.
I went and picked up Mary Liz, and so we went out for sushi.
We had a great time. He was funny, and we laughed. There wasn't a silent moment throughout the entire dinner.
It was fantastic.
So Peter was the second of 4 dates I had in a week. For some reason, all of my friends happened to set me up, and I just could not get him off my mind. So
I think we both had kind of this aha moment that we really, you know, decided we liked each other.
The following day I had a date and he sabotaged the date because he called me right before this guy met me at a restaurant.
The third consecutive blind date, and I do remember that I had emailed her, text messaged her.
And all I could think about during this date was Peter.
I had, in her mind, polluted her date in that she was just unable to have a successful first blind date with this gentleman in Minneapolis. And so I guess, you know, to my advantage, I'd played the chess match well on that.
That guy didn't stand a chance because I already had feelings for Peter.
I felt good. I felt very confident in my wily ways. I certainly feel like I got quite lucky and hit the jackpot on this one.
I remember I talked to Mary Liz afterwards, and she thought Peter was
extraordinary would be the word that I used. In fact, when I came back on Sunday, I was studying, trying not to think about him. And I got so frustrated that I was thinking so much about him that I wrote all the things I liked about him. And I think I came up with a list of 17 things just from the first date.
To have found someone who is so smart, so talented, so beautiful, I just feel like I'm an incredibly fortunate person to have met Mary Liz, and I will be appreciative of Matt Yale's introduction for the rest of our lives.
Then I saw her face. Now I'm a believer.
Right away I knew that this was gonna be the real deal. And then shortly thereafter, we went to the Kentucky Derby, and watching Peter fawn over Mary Liz the entire weekend, I knew that this was going to be a wedding in the near future.
True love is the greatest thing in the world, except for nice MLT.
Well, the advice that I would give Peter and Mary Liz is to have a long fuse and a short memory.
You tell that Kenny, where Paul Lehman.
No, Peter.
Peter Lehman, the way to get ahead in this family is to say, yes, dear.
Mary Liz and I are vastly similar.
We have so much in common. In some ways, we're cut from the same cloth.
That it's almost to the point where we can calculate each other's next moves. It's a little frustrating to try to maintain one's own thoughts when your soon-to-be spouse can know everything that's going on in your head. But we are very similar.
We're definitely stubborn, and both of us very much like to be right.
She is a quintessential oldest child.
And he'll say, "You are such an oldest child."
I'm Jewish, she's Irish. Tomato, tomato. She has shame, I have guilt.
Aaron Gobra, L'chaim.
Did I get that right?
Very good.
I am a self-admitted strange person.
I can't wait till we have kids, because Peter will be a fantastic father. If you've ever seen him with kids, he is a kid. He is a child in a man's body.
He's the greatest uncle, Uncle Petro. And now it's Uncle Petro and Aunt Ollie.
I can't think of one moment where I decided that I was in love with Peter. It was certainly gradual and really started on our first date.
Mary Liz called me the next day after the first date that they had, and she said, "Remember when you told me that Dad still gives you butterflies when he walks into a room?" I said, "Yes." She said,
"I get butterflies when Peter is around."
The first time that I realized that Mary Liz was the person that I wanted to spend the rest of my life with, I was out on the fishing boat with my dad, and I said, "You know, Dad, you know, I'm thinking about taking the next step with Mary Liz, and you know, I want your advice on that."
I really realized how comfortable Peter and Mary Liz were with one another, and how natural and happy they were.
And he said to me, "You know, Peter, I think that you marrying Mary Liz would be a great idea." That was a pretty strong endorsement, and I went ahead and moved forward with my plans.
When he told me he was in love with me and that he wanted to spend the rest of his life with me, and I felt the same way, I was like, when's it gonna happen?
You know, you should sweep me off my feet out yonder window and down a rope onto your valiant steed.
You've had a lot of time to plan this, haven't you?
There was a period of tension where Mary Liz, you know, was expecting to get the ring. We took a couple trips together, it didn't happen.
I mean, when you realize who you want to spend the rest of your life with, you kind of want the life to start right away.
Maybe she picked a fight or two with me because she was perhaps frustrated.
Which was not fair.
So really I wanted to wait for the right time and the right moment.
Look, you love this woman, don't you?
Yes.
You want to hold her?
Yes.
Please her?
Yes.
Then you got to try a little tenderness. The chicks love that romantic crap.
My grandparents, Francie and Elio,
found out that he was serious about Mary Liz. That was when I thought, well, we better give her the ring so that it really works. We can't let her escape, right?
Never would let her get away. Too cute.
I had told Peter that whenever he was ready to become engaged,
to make a real commitment,
I would be happy to give him my ring.
The day of their 65th anniversary,
he whispered to me, "I'm ready to do it.
This is it.
This is it." So I whipped it off right at the table and gave it to him.
The night had finally arrived.
Everyone knew except for me. None of my friends did. I think he didn't trust them.
Mary Liz thought that she was holding all the cards, but I knew better. And it was my birthday, and she thought she was going to surprise me.
I had taken him to True, which is a fantastic restaurant.
Which is the same night that the
White Sox won the World Series. I should have known that something may happen, because he had only asked the server once or twice about the White Sox game.
I had arranged with the staff at True to serve the wedding ring with our dessert course. And then when dessert arrived, they brought two covered platters, lifted one, scribed dessert, lifted the other, and there was the ring box.
The ring box looked like a piece of chocolate cake, a more sophisticated piece of chocolate cake. Then he picked up the chocolate piece of cake and turned to me, and
I made my proposal, and
I think I was still in shock that he had picked up this piece of chocolate cake at True. And he said, "Tully," he calls me Tully, Tully, hello, will you marry me?
She said,
yes, yes, yes.
And that's why we're here doing this video now.
One of the things I most enjoy about my relationship with Peter is that he makes me laugh. And I think that if you can laugh together, you can live together.
What would you do if I sang out of tune? Would you stand up and walk out on me? Lend me your ears and I'll sing you a song. I will try not to sing out of key. Yeah. Oh, baby, how do you know? Certain it happens all the time, yeah.
What do you see when you turn out the light?
I can't tell you, but it sure feels like mad.
I will help,
don't you know I'm on?